I'm going to attempt to do somebody's face, and I'm not going to say who. I'm just going to go ahead and do it and see if you recognize it after a while. It's not going to be a cowboy. Really not sure what it's going to be. I'm going to attempt to make it a historical figure, but I'm not certain how good that's going to work his size. Very hard at this size. Just going to take my time. And the reason I'm doing this attempt here is because it looked to me the same structure as the person's face that I'm trying to do here. Again, I'm not certain it's going to work out, but I thought, what the heck? What's it going to hurt?
It's very safe.
The reason I decided to go or try to attempt to do this gentleman's face is because the overall look of the clay was telling me that it was him that I was looking at. It just needed some adjustments. I'm sorry my thumb's in the way, but it's in the way of my eyes too, so just going by feel here. But I mean, the shape of the face and everything was just telling me it was going to be him. His eyes, not necessarily his mouth at the beginning, but it's getting there. All right, now I gotta work on the nose. Very distinct nose on this gentleman. I'm using Ken's tools here. This is a set of wire tools. It was from kenstools.com. Great tools. A movie industry uses these tools to work on their sculptures for special effects. picture of him with a blanket over his shoulder. And, all right, I'll pick this up tomorrow. Right now, I'm just going to set it aside. I kind of like the way he looks. It has the characteristics of the person I'm doing. And I just will fine-tune it over time. Good night, everybody.